Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss the Hatch-Waxman Act, a critical piece of legislation in the United States that affects both branded and generic drugs. The Hatch-Waxman Act was sponsored by two members of the U.S. Congress, Representative Henry Waxman of California and Senator Orrin Hatch of Utah. The legislation is more properly called the Drug Price Competition and Patent Term Restoration Act. The bill was passed in 1984. The purpose of the legislation was to more fully encourage the introduction of generics into the marketplace. Note that the legislation only applies in the United States market. So the Hatch-Waxman Act carried benefits for generic drug makers. What were those benefits? The legislation allowed generic drug makers to perform research on drugs that were covered under active patents. Before Hatch-Waxman, generic makers could not perform research on patented drugs. The Hatch-Waxman Act also defined a simplified and more rapid approval process for generic drugs. This process is called the abbreviated New Drug Application, or ANDA. Finally, the first generic maker to successfully gain approval under an ANDA receives a 180-day market exclusivity. So for 180 days, there will be only one approved generic drug in the market. And that 180-day window tends to be very profitable for the generic maker. Okay, well, what are the advantages for branded drug manufacturers? There are two main advantages. First, at minimum, a new drug, a new chemical entity, regardless of its remaining patent life, will have at least 5 years of market exclusivity. Second, branded drug makers have the opportunity to recover some of the NDA time period to extend the lifetime of a drug's patent. So if the NDA requires 12 months by the FDA, then some of that time period can be added to the market exclusivity window. Again, this adjustment only occurs within the United States. Europe, Japan, and other nations are not held to the Hatch-Waxman Act. Collectively, these concessions to the generic manufacturers were intended to stimulate the approval of more affordable generic drugs. The concessions to the branded drug makers were necessary to build consensus to pass the legislation. I hope you have a better understanding of how legislation like the Hatch-Waxman Act has improved the availability of safe, effective, and lower-cost generic drugs. If you enjoy the video, please subscribe, leave a like, or make a comment. Take care.